Hello and welcome to English News Bulletin of Hullabol. This is Rashmi here with you. Before moving to the details, at first let us have a look at the day's headlines. Former Chief Minister Manik Sarkar took a dig on the BJP government centering the incident of burning down of CPM party office at Dukli. Friday statement from Tripura Pradesh Congress President Pijush Kanti Bishwas while he addressed the press at Udaipur District Congress Bhavan on Friday. Along with 11 charter point demands, huge number of labourers and workers placed deputation to the Labour Commissioner Agartala. Massive rally organized by farmers' unit in the capital city Agartala demanding withdrawal of farm bills passed by the BJP government. Now the news in details. Forest mafias cutting down large trees while bribing the forest range officer. Incident at Panishagar's Bangshal area. Illegal cutting down of trees while destroying the forest is going on in various hilly areas of the state. According to the details of the incident, the forest pirates under the Panishagar Forest Department of North Tripura District are illegally cutting down large trees in the Bangshal area of Panishagar Thamchara. The infamous forest mafia Bibashnath, a resident of Jolebhasha area under Panishagar police station, is destroying the natural beauty of the hilly region of Tripura by cutting down tree logs, bribing the forest range officer Manimoy Sharma. Moreover, the forest mafia Bibashnath threatened the media not to telecast the news when the reporters went to collect the information. Almost a day ago, Bibashnath was illegally cutting down trees with a lorry numbered TR011635, but the North Tripura District's DFO Vignesh Babu is in deep sleep. Due to such negligence of the Forest Department, the natural beauty of Tripura is on the verge of extinction. Bureau Report, Hullabol. Former MLA of Shabrum Rita Karmachumdar passed away at Shantir Bajar Hospital. Former MP Jiten Chaudhary, MP Jharna Dash Boidya along with several other leaders paid her last tributes. The body of Rita Karmachumdar, former MLA of Shabrum, was brought to the Shabrum Nagar Panchayat office at around 9 AM on Friday morning, where she was paid the last tributes. Ruma Majumdar Bashak, chairperson of Shabrum Nagar Panchayat, garlanded the mortal remains of the senior CPM leader. Several leaders paid homage to the body of Rita Karmachumdar, including Shabrum Panchayat's executive officer Taritkanti Chakma, former Nagar Panchayat chairperson Shanti Priya Bhumik, and former Nagar Panchayat chairperson Biplab Shanyal. Thereafter, the body of the former MLA of Shabrum, Rita Karmachumdar, was brought to the Shabrum Employees Coordination Committee's divisional office, where the members of the committee paid tributes to the body of former MLA. Later, her dead body was brought to the Shabrum Subdivisional Office of the CPIM. CPIM's Shabrum Subdivisional Committee's Secretary Deepak Chaudhary and Basudev Majumdar laid down party's flag over her dead body. Former MP Jiten Chaudhary, Jharna Das Boidya and other leaders paid their last respects with flowers. Party workers and supporters overflowed and marched in the morning procession at Shabrum Town across the streets of Shabrum.
আমাদেরকে এই সমস্ত আক্রমণ মোকাবেলা করার জন্য সাহস যোগাবে আমি বিশ্বাস করি এই জটিল পরিস্থিতিতে এবং কঠিন রাজনৈতিক অর্থনৈতিক সামাজিক যে সমস্যা গোটা দেশব্যাপী এ সময়ে রীতাকরের মতো সাহসী যোদ্ধার খুব প্রয়োজন ছিল যিনি সামনের সারিতে থেকে আমাদের এই যুদ্ধকে পরিচালনা করতে পারতেন। আমরা হারিয়ে ফেলেছি, কিন্তু তার অসমাপ্ত কাজ আমরা আগামী দিনে দৃঢ়তার সঙ্গে এগিয়ে নিয়ে যাব এবং তার প্রতি শ্রদ্ধা জানিয়ে আমি বলবো যে রিতা করের মতো হাজারো কমরেড আমাদের ঘরে ঘরে তৈরি হোক।
আমরা আমাদের এক অনন্য নেত্রীকে সহযোদ্ধাকে হারিয়েছি। তিনি শুধু সামনের সারির একজন যোদ্ধা ছিলেন না, তিনি ছিলেন আমাদের সাবরুম মহকুমার সমস্ত অংশের মানুষের, শ্রমিক, কৃষক, খেটে খাওয়া মানুষ, পাহাড়ি বাঙালি, মহিলা, সমস্ত অংশের মানুষের। আমি ব্যক্তিগতভাবে শুধু একজন কমরেড বা সহযোদ্ধাকে হারাইনি, আমি হারিয়েছি আমার একজন মেহের ছোট বোনকে।
ব্যুরো রিপোর্ট, হাল্লাবোল। In a massive jolt ahead of the Bengal polls, rebel leader Shubhendu Adhikari resigned as the transport minister here on Friday. In a jolt to the Trinamool Congress leadership ahead of the Bengal Assembly polls next year, rebel TMC leader Shubhendu Adhikari tendered his resignation as state transport minister on Friday. The announcement was made by the West Bengal Governor Jagdeep Dhankar, who said that the issue will be addressed from the constitutional perspective. Today at around 1 p.m., a resignation letter of Mr. Shubhendu Adhikari from office as minister addressed to the Honorable Chief Minister has been forwarded to the Mamata Banerjee-led Bengal government had on Thursday replaced Adhikari as chairman of Hooghly River Bridge Commissioners, HRBC, and appointed TMC MP Kalyan Banerjee to the post. In an order issued by the State Transport Department on Thursday evening, Banerjee was named the new HRBC chairman with immediate effect. Sources in the state government, however, said that Adhikari, who is currently maintaining distance from the party and the government, has resigned from the post of HRBC chairman on Wednesday. Bureau report, Hallabol.
Farmers Delhi Chalo Abhiyan effects in Tripura. Massive rally organized by Farmers Unit in the capital city Agartala demanding withdrawal of the farm bills passed by the BJP government.
Opposing the three farm bills introduced by the central government, All India Kisan Sanghash Coordination Committee, AIKSCC, Tripura State Unit, organized a massive protest rally on Friday. The farmers' protest under Delhi March have brought effects in Tripura too, as the leftist farmers' unit held protest demonstration in the heart of capital city, Agartala. Addressing the media on the day's program, senior CPM leader Pavitra Kaur said, farmers of several states of India like Punjab, Haryana, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, etc. have joined hands against the three farm bills and labor bill introduced by the BJP government in the center and are holding Delhi Chalo Abhiyan protest against it. He added, the central government has introduced the policies which are totally against the farmers and laborers.
কে আপনারা দেখেছেন অলরেডি অল ইন্ডিয়া সমস্ত মিডিয়াগুলিতে কৃষকরা আজকে দিল্লি অভিযান করছে। দিল্লি অভিযানে যারা অংশগ্রহণ করবে তারা হইল পাঞ্জাব, হরিয়ানা, রাজস্থান, ছত্তিশগড়, মধ্যপ্রদেশ, তারা আর বাকি সমস্ত রাজ্যে কিষাণ সংঘর্ষ সমিতির আহ্বানে তিনটি কৃষি বিল এবং সেখানে বিদ্যুৎ বেসরকারীকরণ বিল এবং শ্রম বিল যেটা 8 ঘন্টার কাজকে 12 ঘন্টা করে দিয়েছে, এইগুলির প্রতিবাদে আজকে গোটা দেশে বিক্ষোভ হবে।
On the other side, because of anger against the tree farm legislations has been simmering since month of September, for last 3 days, thousands of farmers from Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh have been marching towards the national capital and are nearing the borders. Farmers demanded the union government to withdraw the tree legislations or guarantee them minimum support price or MSP for their crops by introducing a new law. Better report, Hallabol.
Doing such criminal activities, Tripura BJP is losing its own ground. Ex-Chief Minister Manik Sarkar took a dig on the BJP government centering the incident of burning down of the CPIM party office at Dukli.
CPIM Dukli area's party office was allegedly set on fire by the ruling BJP activist at late hours of Thursday night. During the nationwide strike called by the trade unions in support of various demands, the BJP workers attacked the CPIM party office at Dukli. Friday, after visiting the party office, former Chief Minister Manik Sarkar said, "The BJP-led government in Tripura is destroying the state and their workers are attacking the democratic movements and national party offices in Tripura."
ये मैंने party office भांगचूर, लूंठन, बेदखल, अग्निसंयोग, एगुली मूलत তাদের মানে শাসক দলের নিজেদের ব্যর্থতা ডাকবার জন্য জনবিচ্ছিন্নতা থেকে নিজেদের অস্তিত্ব রক্ষার জন্য এই কাণ্ডকারখানা তারা করে চলেছে দিনে দিনে এটা বাড়াবার চেষ্টা করছেন মাঝে মাঝে একটু স্থিমিত হয় আবার তারা এটা বাড়াবার চেষ্টা করে কালকে যেমন হয়েছে আগরতলা সহ বিভিন্ন জায়গায়
Activities BJP is only losing its ground and it will cause their political loss only. He added, in whole country the BJP has set an anarchy and in various states various types of rules are set by the BJP. In Tripura, fascist style is going on. At yesterday's 24 hours nationwide strike called by the trade unions, various CPIM party offices were vandalized from Shabrum to Agartala. Party workers were attacked physically. Moreover, the role of police was mute. In spite of all such criminal activities in open, nobody has been arrested so far in connection with the incidents. However, amid all such preventions, threatening and use of force, the strike remained successful as public gave massive response to the strike. Bureau report, Halabol.
Fiery statement from Tripura Pradesh Congress President Piyush Kanti Bishwas while he addressed the press at Udaipur District Congress Bhavan on Friday. Let's look into the report.
Tripura Pradesh Congress President Piyush Kanti Bishwas visited Udaipur District Congress Bhavan on Friday. There he attended the mourning ceremony of former Chief Minister of Assam Tarun Gogoi and MP Ahmed Patel and paid tributes to the senior Congress leaders. In the program, other than Tripura Pradesh Congress President Piyush Kanti Bishwas, Gomati District Congress President Soumitra Bishwas along with District Congress leaders and members remained present. Later, Piyush Bishwas attended a press conference at around 1:30 p.m. that was organized centering the upcoming ADC election and municipality election. Where addressing the press, Pradesh Congress President Piyush Bishwas made an explosive comment that has created a resented atmosphere in the ruling BJP party of the state.
তারপরে তো আপনার সময় দেখবেন কে কোথায়
সাতজন বিধায়ক কে কে এটা কি
বলতে আমি নাম বললে তো
কি কথা হয়েছে ওই সাতজন বিধায়কের
সাথে আমি নাম বলতে হবে না আপনার নাম নিয়ে আস্তে আস্তে জেনে যাবেন কে কত প্রকাশ্য বলছে দেখবেন এর মধ্যে তো দুজন এমএলএ প্রকাশ্য বলছে বলছে একজন বলছে আমি আইন মন্ত্রীর কাছে বুঝাতে গিয়েছিলাম দলের ক্ষতি এরকম ভাবে চললে দল থাকবে না আইন মন্ত্রী বলছে বিজেপি দল এসে হাওয়া চলে যাবে হাওয়া তোমার আর আমার কি এটা তো সে বলছে আমার ভিডিও আছে আমি বলবো তারপর ভগবান দাসের কথা আজকে আমি পত্রিকা দেখলাম বড় ইন্টারভিউ সে তো পুরোটাই বলেছে যে এই একটা গভর্নমেন্ট আমি যখন চিৎকার করছি তখন কেউ আমাকে পাত্তা দেয়নি আট দিনের মাথায় যখন খুন পড়ে গেল খুন হয়ে গেল বলছে আরো যে এর আগে দুই একটা মিটিং হয়েছে আমি এলাকার বিধায়ক আমার আগে ডাকে না আমি যেহেতু সরকারের সমালোচনা করেছি কাজের মুখ্যমন্ত্রী কাজের সমালোচনা সেই জন্য আমাকে কোনো মিটিংয়ে ডাকে না
Piyush Bishwas claimed that the current ruling party in Tripura could break up at any moment, adding that seven MLAs from the ruling BJP party are in touch with Tripura State Congress President. After the explosive comment at the press conference, there is a huge buzz ongoing in the political arena of the entire state. However, Pradesh Congress President Piyush Bishwas denied to reveal the name of any MLA in that regard. However, the people of the state are well aware that about 15 dissident MLAs are rebelling against Tripura Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb. If all of them leaves the BJP and joins the Congress, the existence of BJP in Tripura will come under huge threat. Bureau report, Halabol.
along with 11 charter point demands. Huge number of laborers and workers under 8 workers union placed deputation to the labor commissioner Agartala on Friday. 8 labor wings of Tripura along with several demands placed mass deputation to the labor commissioner on Friday. Along with 11 charter point demands, the workers under various sectors like footpath hawkers, auto rickshaw drivers, e-rickshaw, private school bus drivers and conductors, salon workers, etc. in huge number placed deputation. Among the 11 demands, the major demands include paying rupees 1000 to the rickshaw, e-rickshaw, auto drivers, motor workers and salon workers immediately as per Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb's promise to fight the crisis period followed by the COVID pandemic. To form Motor Welfare Society in order to secure the future of the state's motor workers, they demanded the government to immediately restart facilities of labor card and pay the amount that got collected in past 3 years. They demanded the government to pay the pending salaries during the lockdown of the bus drivers and conductors running private schools and colleges bus. Also to introduce modern and simple techniques of teaching for the home tutors in the state. Talking on this issue while naming the unions that participated in the mass deputation, chairman of two of the unions said,
All Tripura Nirman Shramik Samiti, Tripura Footpath Hawker Sangram Samiti, Tripura Rajya Motor Sangram Samiti, Tripura Rajya Griho Paricharika Samiti, Tripura Rajya Salon Kormi Samiti. এবং এরকম আটটা উইংস আজকে আমরা ঐক্যবদ্ধ হয়ে 11 দফা দাবি নিয়ে আজকে শ্রম দপ্তরের মাননীয় কমিশনারের কাছে শ্রমিকদের বিভিন্ন সমস্যা নিয়ে আমরা ওনার কাছে সমর্পণ হচ্ছি এবং ওনার সাথে ডিটেলস আলোচনা করব সে আলোচনা করে একটা সলিউশন বের করে আনার চেষ্টা করব এবং কাজ করতে গিয়ে তাদের বিভিন্ন ফেসিলিটিস পেতে গিয়ে আমাদের যে যে সমস্যাগুলো হচ্ছে সেই সমস্যাগুলো ওনার কাছে তুলে দেব
The laborers and workers gathered in large number and hoped that the government and its administration will have a kind glance on their demands and fulfill them accordingly. Bureau report, Halabol. Protesting against the incident of vandalizing a shop at Badharghat market by the BJP miscreants during the ongoing nationwide strike on Thursday, Pradesh Congress President Pijush Kanti Bishwash took a toll on the misrule going on in the state under BJP's Hira era. During the ongoing nationwide strike hours on Thursday, the BJP Mandal president locked the shop of a helpless woman at Badharghat Chomani adjacent to the Ram Thakur College. Later, the BJP goons allegedly vandalized the shop during the night hours of Thursday. Centering this inhuman incident, Pradesh Congress President Pijush Kanti Bishwash placed a deputation to the OC of Edinagar Police Station on Friday. Talking to the reporters on this issue, Pijush Bishwash said, Gunda Raj is going on in the state. People are threatened by the ruling party using ruffians. But the police role is completely mute. He added, In fact, yesterday many criminal activities took place in front of the police at various parts of the Agartala city. But police remained silent spectators. Over the incident of vandalizing the shop of Congress worker at Badharghat, Pijush Bishwash said, Concrete evidence is there in this case, that is, the CCTV footage and guards of Badharghat market. He further added, The police is in fact used as the dolls of the ruling BJP. They are not taking any action despite of the wrongdoings in front of them.
গুন্ডারা শাসন করছে গুন্ডাদেরকে দিয়ে ভয়ভীতি দেখাচ্ছে আর এই পুলিশ প্রশাসন যেন নীরব কালকে আমি অনেকগুলো ইনসিডেন্ট দেখেছি পুলিশের সামনে মানুষকে আক্রমণ করছে ভাঙচুর করছে পুলিশ দাঁড়িয়ে দাঁড়িয়ে দেখছে এখানে কংক্রিট এভিডেন্স পাওয়া যাবে চারজন এখানে বাজারে গার্ড থাকে তারপরে সিসি ক্যামেরা আছে তারপর দুপুরবেলায় তাণ্ডব করেছে রাত্রেবেলায় এটা ভেঙে নিয়েছে 2 থেকে 2.5 ঘন্টা রাজ্যটা
Pijush Bishwash slammed the state government, adding that the BJP party has lost its popularity in the state. When the members of the ruling party are themselves annoyed of the misrule going on, one can well imagine what is the thinking of the common people. Bureau report, Halabol.
Three more pairs of special short-distance trains to run from the first week of December.
North East Frontier Railway, in a press release on 27th of November, declared that three more pairs of short-distance special trains will run from the first week of December. Also, the services of the special train from Guwahati to Silchar extended from 1st of December with revised timings. This has been decided keeping in view the requirements of short-distance rail travellers. Train number 05895 Rangia Murkong Select Express Special will leave from Rangia on 8:50 hours every day except Saturday to reach Murkong Select at 20:50 hours on the same day. The other two pairs of special trains will run between Sialdah and Saharsa. The trains are 03169 Sialdah Saharsa Special and train number 03163 Sialdah Saharsa Special. Moreover, the Silchar Guwahati Express Special train number 05612 will leave from Silchar 3 days in a week, that is Wednesday, Friday and Sunday at 22:10 hours. Bureau report, Halabol.
Well, that's all from the English Bulletin at this moment. For more news and updates, keep tuning into Halabol.